नमस्कार। टुडे वी आर स्टार्टेड सेशन नंबर 2, चैप्टर 2, रिप्रोडक्शन इन लोअर एंड हायर एनिमल। टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग टॉपिक मेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम। सो मेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम कंसिस्ट ऑफ पेयर्स ऑफ टेस्टिस, accessory dug, accessory gland and external genitalia. So male reproductive system consists of pair of testes, accessory dug, accessory gland and external genitalia.
Testes. The male gonad are testes situated in the scrotum. A pouch of pigmented skin arising from the lower abdominal wall is called as a scrotum. Each testes are soft, smooth, pinkish oval, measure about 4.5 cm in length, 3 cm thickness and 2.5 cm width. The scrotum wall consists of smooth muscle called as a Dartos tunic muscle, a vertical septum of subcutaneous tissue in the center divided into two parts, right and left, and each part containing one testes. Each testes is connected to the wall of scrotum by short fibromuscular band called as a gubernaculum. Scrotum provide a temperature about 3 degrees Celsius below the normal body temperature. The lower temperature is necessary for the production of viable sperm. So now in the diagram I will show you the testes. These are the male reproductive system. In this diagram, we can easily observe the pair of testes. So this pair of testes are the male gonads and they are present in the pigmented skin called as a scrotum. Pigmented skin is called as a scrotum. So testes are the soft, pinkish, oval organ. मेजरिंग कितना है उसका, 4.5 सेंटीमीटर लॉन्ग, 2.5 सेंटीमीटर वाइड एंड 3 सेंटीमीटर थिक। सो नाउ दिस टेस्टिस, ईच टेस्टिस इज कनेक्टेड टू द वॉल ऑफ स्कॉटम। आप डायग्राम में देख सकते हैं आप लोग, टेस्टिस इज कनेक्टेड टू द वॉल ऑफ स्कॉटम बाय शॉर्ट फाइब्रोमस्कुलर बैंड। दिस बैंड इज कॉल्ड एज अ गुबरनेकुलम। This band is called as a gubernaculum. So in the diagrams, we can easily observe the fibromuscular band which help to connect testes to the scrotum. These are called as a gubernaculum. And now, what is Dartos muscles? That each testes, the scrotum. Scrotum is composed of smooth muscle. This muscle is called as a Dartos tunic muscle.
Now the next topic is a histology of testes. Externally, each testes is covered by three layers: tunica vaginalis, tunica albuginea, and tunica vasculosa. So now in this diagram we can easily observe the tunica albuginea. So externally, testes cover with three layers. First layer is tunica vaginalis. It is outermost cover of testes is called as a tunica vaginalis. So it is lined by visceral layer of peritoneum. Second layer is a tunica albuginea. We can easily observe in the diagram. So it is a dense fibrous cover called as a tunica albuginea. And the last one is a tunica vasculosa, which is present below the tunica albuginea. So it consists of connective tissue and blood vessels. Consists of connective tissue and blood vessels. So tunica vasculosa consists of connective tissue and blood vessels. So these are the three layer externally covered to the testes. So Now next one is the internal structure of the testes. So each testes has 250 compartment called as the testicular lobules. Okay, each lobule consists of 3 seminiferous tubules. We can easily observe the seminiferous tubule which is present in the testes. So in this diagram we can easily observe the 3 seminiferous tubules present in the compartment. So each lobule consists of 3 seminiferous tubule. This seminiferous tubule is lined by cuboidal epithelial cell. Cuboidal epithelial cell, we can easily observe in the diagram. So each seminiferous tubule is lined by cuboidal epithelial cell, and this cuboidal epithelial cell is interrupted by many pyramid shaped Sertoli cell. So now this cuboidal epithelial cell undergoes meiosis to produce haploid sperm. This process is called as a spermatogenesis. So in the process of spermatogenesis, the cuboidal epithelial layer of the seminiferous tubule undergoes meiosis to form haploid sperms. So in between this cuboidal epithelial cell, there is a large pyramid cells are present. These cells is called as a Sertoli cell. This Sertoli cell provide nourishment to the developing sperms. So these are the seminiferous tubules. So seminiferous tubules show a number of haploid sperms, developing sperms. In between the seminiferous tubules, the group of cells are present called as a interstitial cell. So we can easily observe in this diagram the interstitial cell or leading cell. This interstitial cell or leading cell secrete male testosterone hormone. So male hormone, testosterone hormone, is responsible for the secondary sexual character in male. Once upon, I will repeat, the histology of testes. Each testes is covered with 3 layer: tunica vascularis, albuginea, and tunica vasculosa. Now each testes consists of 200 compartment of testicular lobules. Each lobule consists of 3 seminiferous tubule. The seminiferous tubule is lined by cuboidal epithelial cell. This cuboidal epithelial cell interrupted by many pyramid shaped Sertoli cell. During spermatogenesis, the cuboidal epithelial cell undergoes meiosis to form haploid sperms, while Sertoli cell provide nourishment to the developing sperms. In between the seminiferous tubules, there is a interstitial cell or leading cell present. These cells are responsible to secrete male sex hormone testosterone. Testosterone responsible for the secondary sexual character in male. So these are histology of. Now next topic is the accessory duct. In male reproductive system, 3 accessory ducts are there: vasa efferentia, epididymis, and vas deferens. The first one is the vasa efferentia. So we can easily observe in this diagram vasa efferentia. So seminiferous tubule of the testes open into the vasa efferentia through the reed testes. We can easily observe here the reed testes. So seminiferous tubules connected to the reed testes, and this reed testes connected to the vasa efferentia. So seminiferous tubule open into the vasa efferentia through the reed testes. Vasa efferentia leave the testes and open into the epididymis. So now in this diagram easily shows the vasa efferentia. So vasa efferentia, here the seminiferous tubules are there. The seminiferous tubules open into the red testes, and red testes connected to the vasa efferentia. Vasa efferentia open into the epididymis. So second one is the epididymis. Epididymis is a 6 meter long coil tube found in the posterior lateral side of the each testis. We can easily observe the epididymis, which is present on the found on the lateral side of the each testis. So now this epididymis divided into the 3 parts: a upper caput. We can easily observe in the diagram the uppermost caput. This part is a wide and receive vasa efferentia. Middle one is a corpus. It stores sperms for shorter duration, which undergoes maturation. So in corpus region, the sperm undergoes maturation. It lies in the lateral side of the testis. We can easily observe caput. Then second one is a corpus epididymis, and third one is a lower cauda. So before entering the vasa deferens, the spermatozoa is stored here. So in lower cauda, the spermatozoa temporarily store. This part lies on the caudal side of the testis and it is a wide. So now epididymis, we can easily observe in accessory duct. We can easily observe the epididymis. Okay, now this epididymis consists of caput, corpus and cauda three region. So in which the corpus is a site present in the middle of the epididymis, and it is a maturation site of the sperm. Here the sperm undergoes maturation, while in the cauda the sperms are temporarily stored before it passes into the vas deferens. So now the third accessory duct is a vas deferentium. It is called as a seminal duct. Vas deferentia is called as a seminal duct. So in this diagram we can easily observe the vas deferens, the accessory duct. It is also called as a seminal duct. Vas deferentia is also called as a seminal duct. It is about 330 cm long, narrow, muscular and tubular structure. It starts from the tail of the epididymis, that is cauda region, and passes through the inguinal canal, then over the urinary bladder, and then joined to the duct of seminal vesicle to form ejaculatory ducts. So in this diagram we can easily observe the vas deferens. It is about 30 cm long. It arising from the cauda epididymis, connected to the seminal vesicles to form common ejaculatory duct, and it passes to the inguinal canal. So this diagram is also shows a vasa deferens, the long tubular structure about 30 cm long arising from the cauda epididymis and joined to the seminal vesicle to form common ejaculatory duct. Now the next is a ejaculatory duct. These are the pair of duct, each about 2 cm long. It formed by the joining of vas deferens and duct of seminal vesicle. Both the ejaculatory duct open into the urethra in the region of prostate gland. Ejaculatory duct carry the seminal fluid and spermatozoa to the urethra. So now in this diagram we can easily observe the ejaculatory duct. So ejaculatory duct is about 2 cm long. It formed from the joining of vas deferens and seminal vesicles, and it open into the urethra region. It carry semen into the urethra. So these are called as the ejaculatory duct. So now the next topic is a urethra. Urethra is a passage of sperm and fluid from the reproductive system and urine from the urinary system. So it is a common passage of sperm and urine. The male urethra is divided into the three parts: prostatic urethra, which is present near the prostatic gland, where the number of prostatic duct open into this urethra. So it receives ejaculatory duct, which contains sperm and secretion of seminal vesicle and numerous duct from the prostatic gland. Second one is a membranous urethra. It is short region that passes through the pelvic floor. And third one is a penile urethra.
It is also called as a spongy urethra or cavernous urethra. The duct from the bulbo urethral gland, these are also called as a copper gland, open into the penile urethra. So penile urethra is guarded by two sphincter, internal sphincter lined by smooth muscle, while external sphincter lined by striated muscle. So these are the structure of urethra. So in this diagram we can easily observe the urethra. Urethra is a common passage of seminal fluid and urine in the male. So it's a long straight tube, consists of main three parts. First one is a prostatic urethra. This prostatic urethra present near the prostatic gland here. Okay, now in this prostatic urethra, the numerous duct of prostatic gland, seminal fluid of the ejaculatory duct are pour into this region. Second one is a membranous urethra. Membranous urethra present between prostatic gland and towards copper glands. In between the prostatic gland and copper glands, urethra is present, is called as a middle membranous urethra. While penile urethra present from the copper gland to the towards the penis. So it is called as a spongy urethra. It consists of two sphincter, internal sphincter lined by smooth muscle and external sphincter lined by striated muscle. So these are the part of urethra. Urethra is a common passage of seminal fluid and urine in male. Next one is a penis. Penis is a male genitalia. It is an erectable copulatory cylindrical organ. It is made up of three erectable tissue. The two posterior tissue, erectable tissue, made up of yellow fibrous ligament called as a corpus cavernosa, while one anterior spongy and highly vascular corpus spongiosum. It is surrounded the urethra, penile urethra. So now in this diagram we can easily, so penis act as a copulatory organ. It is highly erectable. It consists of three erectable tissue, two posterior corpus cavernosa and one anterior corpus spongiosum. This tissue, erectable tissue, present in the penis, and it is a cylindrical copulatory organ present in the, it is surrounded to the penile urethra. Penis is surrounded to the urethra. The tip of the penis is highly sensitive. It's called as a gland penis. It is a rectatable fold of skin of gland penis, and it is also known as foreskin or prepuce. The erection of penis is due to the rush of arterial blood into the sinus of corpus spongiosum. Penis function as a copulatory organ. So erection of this penis during copulation is occur due to the rush of arterial blood into the sinuses of corpus spongiosum. So corpus spongiosum, which is the anterior most erectable tissue, which is filled with the blood, and because of it filled with the blood, it become erectable. The main function of this penis is a copulatory organ. Now next topic is a accessory sex gland. So in male reproductive system, the accessory sex gland are seminal vesicle, prostate gland and Cowper's gland. The first one is the seminal vesicles. You can easily observe the seminal vesicle in the diagram. The seminal vesicles are the pair of seminal secretory gland posterior to the urinary bladder. Each gland has short duct that join with the common ejaculatory duct. The fluid from the seminal vesicle is a viscous and contain fructose, fibrinogen and prostaglandin. So seminal vesicle fluid contain fructose, fibrinogen and prostaglandin. So first, fructose provide energy to the sperm. Prostaglandin, which contribute for the mobility and viability of the sperm. So thin containers may fructose, prostaglandin, fructose provide energy to the sperm. Prostaglandin provide mobility and viability to the sperm, while fibrinogen protein causes slight coagulation reaction in the semen after ejaculation. After ejaculation, the semen becomes coagulate. It becomes semi-solid because of fibrinogen protein. So now these are the seminal vesicles. Once again, I will repeat. Seminal vesicles are the pair of gland present posterior to the urinary bladder. It is short duct joined with the common ejaculatory duct. It secretes seminal fluid which contains fructose, fibrinogen and prostaglandin. Fructose provide energy to the sperm. Prostaglandin contribute the mobility and viability of the sperm, while fibrinogen causes slightly coagulation reaction in the semen after ejaculation. So these are the accessory duct. The next accessory duct is the prostate gland. The prostate gland is a dense structure that located just inferior to the urinary bladder. So in this diagram, we can easily observe the prostate gland. So it is just located inferior to the urinary bladder. It is about walnut size and encircle the urethra and leave the urinary bladder. The numerous prostate duct open into the prostatic urethra. The secretion of prostate gland are thin, milky color and highly alkaline. It increases the mobility of the sperm. Okay, now these are the second accessory gland, prostate gland. Prostate gland present inferior to the urinary bladder. It is a walnut size. The numerous prostate duct open into the prostatic urethra. It secretes thin, milky color, alkaline fluid, which increase the mobility of sperm. So these are the prostate gland. Now the third one is a Cowper's gland. These are the pair of bulbo urethral gland. These are the small size, near about pea size. It located near the base of penis. It is short duct gland enter to the penile urethra. So in this diagram we can easily observe the prostate gland. It is about pea size gland. These are the pair of Cowper gland and open into the penile urethra. It, in response to the sexual stimulation, this Cowper gland secrete alkaline mucus fluid. During intercourse, this Cowper gland secrete alkaline mucus fluid. This fluid neutralizes the acidity of urine residues in the urethra. It also helps to neutralize vagina, because vagina is acidic in nature. So this acidic vagina neutralized by this Cowper gland secretion. It provides some lubrication for the tip of the penis during intercourse. So main function of this Cowper gland, it secrete viscous alkaline fluid which neutralizes the acidity of the urine in the urethra. Second function, it neutralizes the acidic vagina during intercourse. It also provides some lubricant to the tip of the penis during sexual intercourse. So these are the Cowper gland. Okay, so today this topic is finished. Okay, thank you, bye, take care.